are we today?
Hi.
Hi. I had so much fun with Emily in Paris season two. But starting with you, Samuel, I feel like Julien and Emily are not having as much fun at the start. Their friendship hits a little bit of a snag in the workplace. Can you talk about that new dynamic?
Yeah, I feel like I actually really like that because like it shows how Julien is competitive, you know? But it doesn't really affect their friendship because underneath you can see the love, you know, it's all love in the end.
I love that. They are adorable and yet even when they're fighting, so that's the best. On the other hand, Sylvie gets to explore a little bit more romance this season. We opened the door a little bit last season. This season we get a wider breadth, if you will. Philippine, can you talk about that side of her, seeing her outside of the workplace and how love and work mix?
Well, we realized that she's much more complicated than we thought. And also that she was probably, as a young girl, wilder than she looks, you know, now. And so that's really interesting. She had to suppress and constrain something to become Sylvie in Savoir. Otherwise, before, she was, you know, a wilder person, which I really like. And yeah, and becomes very complicated because we discover a lot of things in her personal life. And also she has to deal with this big challenge of this American invasion and takeover of the agency, which she's going to deal with she's really overwhelmed at a certain point, but then she's strong enough to find the solution.
Of course, and that is why we stand. Sam, on the romance front, Julien does not get as many cracks at it as other people in the show, and I would like to see more. But what do you think is his take on romance?
Well, I feel like he's a bit of a, you know, he's a bit of a player, you know, he's a free electron, you know, like free bird. He's a free bird, so yeah, he's just flirting around, you know what I mean?
Philippine, can you talk about how your relationship with Emily grows this season? It seems like Emily and Sylvie are a little bit more understanding of one another, and yet there is still tension, of course.
I think that Sylvie really is Emily's mentor, and she's having her pass through trials in season one, too. Season two is even more obvious. She wants her to grow as a woman. You know, whereas in season one, we saw that Sylvie was scared of Emily and she was a bit jealous of Emily. In season two, we see that she's decided to be more of a mature woman that makes a younger woman grow. So she's going to make her go through a lot of obstacles and trials in order to achieve that. And so it's a tough love. It's love, but it's a tough love.
And it is great to witness. Also great to witness are the many clients that come through Savoir. We get obviously some of our old favorites and new ones this season. Do you guys have a Savoir client you are particularly fond of?
Yes, Dior.
Do tell.
The Vespa was cool. It really, really looked good.
No, I remember. Remember the guy that was selling us the bicycle, Peloton? Pelotec? Oh my God,
funny.
That was so much
fun.
That was so, that man, that actor was incredible. He was so good. He was so good. That was like a real moment of fun for me.
And the vegetables. The vegetables guys.
Oh, and the vegetable guys, the poivre guys.
I mean,
they're amazing.
We love our clients.
We love our clients. We love them all.
That's good. That's how you do your job.
Right.
Finally, is there any lesson that you took either for your character or for yourself as an actor from season one that you then applied to season two?
Wow. That's a tough question. You left it for last, right?
I think like on my end is like trusting the process, trusting the work, trusting people around you. And it makes it very easy.
Yeah.
It felt very easy working with everybody and trusting yourself on that show. That was like, it made the work easy.
I can't top that one. Thank you, Sam.
It's a good lesson for us all.
Yeah.
Thank you guys so much. I can't wait for everyone to watch. It was a great time.